Aquateam is boarding the coolest sailboat in the world, the Cuan Law. We're about to explore a deadly shipwreck and mysterious caves, searching for pirate treasure. Aquateam is setting sail for Treasure Island.
Aquateam is in the British Virgin Islands. It's a group of more than 50 islands in the Caribbean. We're about to board the Cuan Law. It's a trimaran. That means it has three parts that sit in the water. And the Cuan Law is the biggest sailing trimaran in the world.
Because it has three hulls, it means it doesn't tip.
There it is.
Oh.
Oh my God!
Oh my God!
On the deck, there's two 14-foot Hobie cats, there's a chef downstairs, but in the rooms are nice, we checked it out, and there's big zodiacs, and I'm psyched!
We're heading to Norman Island. It's the place from the book Treasure Island, but on the Cuan Law, getting there is half the fun.
Everyone is searching for
piece of string.
That's amazing.
So push the S, and you'll get the S. That's it, you're now steering. So if you turn a little bit to the right, which is starboard, this is a GPS and chart plotter, another GPS and chart plotter. We've got our radar as well. This is a rudder indicator, which shows you what the rudder's actually doing. So now we can straighten up, so put this to naught. Perfect, and you steer around that island beautifully.
Whoa. Oh my God! I didn't even see
it! You didn't see that, did you?
Oh man.
On the way to Treasure Island, we're going to dive the Rhone. People say it's the most spectacular shipwreck in the Caribbean.
My name is Kumi. We're gonna dive the Rhone today.
The Rhone was a Royal Mail packet steamer that went down in 1867. She was taken down by, at the time, what was called the Great Hurricane. She, through a series of events, ended up hitting a rock around the corner from here. The water came in, blew up the boilers, and the ship went down. A lot of people, unfortunately, lost their lives in the event. However, the Salt Islanders of the time went out in their little boats during the middle of the hurricane, recovered all of the bodies and gave them good Christian burials, and the graveyard is on Salt Island, so you guys can check that out tomorrow.
So right now we're on the Cuan Law and we're about to go diving on the Rhone, and it's gonna be really cool because there are tons of artifacts left over from when the boilers exploded.
The reef where the Rhone sank is still a dangerous spot. It's way too shallow to take a big boat like the Cuan Law. So we're going to take Zodiacs over to the dive site.
Dart my eyes and everything will work out fine.
Please swim along to the front of the boats and then we're going to go down the mooring line. Okay, if you guys drop in where you are, it's relatively deep and you won't actually see anything. So on the surface, please swim to the front and then we'll go down the mooring line all together. Everybody understand?
Yeah.
Ollie has dove the Rhone dozens of times, so it was great to have him there to show us all of the different parts of the wreck.
The Rhone
wreck is voted the number one wreck in the Caribbean, and I think we all found out why. It was crazy. It was bursting with life, all the coral growing around it. I saw black coral. I've never seen that one before.
You can still see the Rhone's boilers. You can see how the explosion ripped them apart when the cold water hit them. Built in the days when bigger was considered better. So the propeller and rudder are massive.
We looked at the propeller and the rudder, and they were huge. Like, the ones on that boat were just ginormous.
Silver cutlery at the captain's table. So we knew this was the captain's spoon. It's all grown over with coral now.
It was amazing. We got down there and we did everything we needed to do. We looked at the silver spoon.
We all rubbed the lucky brass porthole. The glass was still intact. It was all still there.
This porthole didn't break during the explosion, so rubbing it is supposed to be good luck. We were also trying to see the lucky number engraved on it.
It was amazing. We went and looked at the what's called the lucky porthole, and it was still all brass. There's still the glass in it.
The glass was still there, yeah. It was a little cracked though, but it was still there.
And the lucky number is 26. We're going to a beach on Salt Island.
And we're gonna go see if we can find the graves of the victims of the Rhones.
Sometimes it's easy to forget that some of the most beautiful shipwrecks come from horrible tragedies. More than 100 people died when the Rhone exploded. The island where they're buried is just a few hundred meters from where it sank. We decided to sail over to Salt Island and pay our final respects to the victims of the Rhone.
We made it to Salt Island, and we're gonna go check out some graves. Kind of spooked about that, but pretty cool.
That is freaky. It looks like they didn't like dig a hole to put them in. It looks like they just put rocks on the bodies. That's weird. That is freaky.
I'm just kind of surprised they lasted this long, because usually when there are graves really close to the ocean, sometimes they have problems with the water and stuff. But they seem totally fine. There's actually some dead coral on top of them.
What do you guys think about getting in and looking a bit closer?
No.
You can go in.
Go ahead, though.
I kind of want to.
Go ahead.
You read it.
No one's stopping.
Hopefully it's not, like, super haunted and I'm, like,
well,
gonna get haunted.
Well, if you're looking for somewhere haunted, this would probably be the place.
The Aqua Team is heading for Treasure Island aboard the coolest sailboat in the world, the Cuan Law. But first we stopped and dove a beautiful shipwreck. Now we're visiting Salt Island to pay respects to the people who died when the ship exploded.
What do you guys think about getting in and looking a bit closer?
No.
Hopefully it's not like super haunted and I'm like,
well,
gonna get haunted.
Site. If you're looking for somewhere haunted, this would probably be the place. Watch out, I'm pretty sure those have thorns in them. Or at least
waiting
really
for a head to pop out.
Please something scary happen. I don't know.
This wood looks so old.
Wrong about it.
Come on in. It's not there. It was like 200 years ago. Goosebumps. I would never touch. This could turn into like a horror movie. I would never touch.
Do you see any like bones or anything?
I was looking, but I didn't see any. Nope.
Look at that. It looks like a hand popping out.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
So this looks like it was someone important because there's a nice conch shell, some brain coral, and really, really nice rocks.
Hey, you guys, so this is pretty creepy. Do you want to go check out some other parts of the island?
Yes, please.
Sure.
This is about like, yes, please.
So, do you guys know why they call it Salt Island? Basically, see all this white stuff here? That's all salt. So what happens is the ocean water comes in and then fills up this whole pond. And what happens is, because it's so hot, the water evaporates. So what's left is salt. So this stuff is exactly, like if you get sea salt, this is what you get. Try it.
Looks like snow. I don't really want to eat it.
I hate salt. Why did I try it?
Whoa!
Yeah.
Wait.
It's totally salt.
It's confirmed that it's totally salt.
That is salt.
Now we're heading to Norman Island, the real-life place that inspired the book Treasure Island. Treasure Island is just a story, but there's been real pirate gold found in the caves on Norman Island before. We're going to explore the caves ourselves to see what we can find.
That was good.
We are going to go with Ollie and explore the Treasure Island caves.
Oh, very nice. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you have any advice about it?
Well, there's a nice little dinghy mooring just over there, between the two blue mooring balls. It's a very short swim over into the caves, and yeah, you should have some good fun over there.
The guys on the Cuan Law say they know three awesome caves for us to explore.
Are also the place where they supposedly found the treasure in the book.
Amongst the walls, you'll find small amounts of chewing gum sponges, which look like bits of chewing gum splattered on the pavement, but it's a very colourful sponge. You'll also find several sea urchins, so do be careful when you go in there. There are bats up in the ceiling, up in the top, so if you do see something, please try not to disturb it too much, otherwise you might have them all come down on you.
We're starting with the easiest caves first. You can get into the first two caves from the surface. So we're going to ditch the heavy scuba gear and just use our snorkels.
The caves were amazing. You could totally imagine a pirate stashing his gold in here. It would be the perfect hiding spot.
I was totally scared the cave would be full of bats. But luckily, we didn't find any.
One cave down, and no pirate treasure. On to the next cave. It's supposed to be a little trickier to get into.
Whoa.
The second cave was a lot darker and a lot scarier.
I really didn't know what to expect, but I think the first thing I noticed was probably how narrow the passageway just to get through was.
It was so dark. It was totally freaky.
But it was nice because you could, like, at one point it was shallow enough to stand up. We were definitely afraid the bats were just gonna come out of nowhere and just, like, fly at our faces.
Yeah, we were all checking the ceilings, but then checking underneath, too, to see what we were standing on.
Yeah, it was, like, half wanting to make sure that your feet were, like, safe.
We went in and saw some little fish, some cool stuff, but no bats.
That was really fun. I don't go snorkeling very often just because we're usually diving, but I like snorkeling.
It's weird to think that these were the very caves that inspired the story to Treasure
Island. I know, we didn't see any treasure, so but it was still cool. But yeah, I want to go in the third one over there.
Yeah, it's kind of creepy.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
The first two caves were amazing, but the last cave is the deepest and darkest, the best place to hide something. So we're going to suit up in our scuba gear and finish exploring Treasure Island.
See you later.
The Aquateam is on the real Treasure Island. In the book, the treasure was hidden in the caves. We've explored two caves so far, but we're heading back with our scuba gear to look in the deepest, darkest cave yet.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah, ready? All right. Okay. Normally, I'm really scared of jellyfish, but these are called moon jellyfish. They don't have any stingers, so you can reach right out and touch them.
The third cave dive we did was definitely the deepest and the darkest. None of us really knew what to expect.
The one thing I probably remember most is the fish. Like, I remember they were just all really tiny.
Yeah, they were all like minnows.
We had to swim through them. They would, like, brush up against our hands.
Yeah. Like, the water was so clear, but then the fish were actually, there were so many of them, they were making the visibility bad.
It was really weird, though, because you'd think that they'd be, like, touching you everywhere, yeah. But when you actually went to, like, make a move, they would dart out so quickly.
These caves weren't full of treasure like the one in the book, but they were filled with life. We saw all sorts of fish and sponges we'd never seen anywhere else.
I'm really glad we dived it instead of snorkeled it, because it was deep enough for us to really dive it.
Yeah, but it was great because it wasn't small enough to be scary, like claustrophobic or anything, but it was small enough for it to actually have like a whoa factor.
We didn't find any treasure, but we learned a lot about these islands and saw an amazing shipwreck. The radio report says there's a huge storm coming, and we need to get the Cuan Law back into port before it arrives. I was hosing them down when the cop showed up. It was extraordinary. Extraordinary.
Before we explore Treasure Island, I think we should go snorkeling.
It'd be really nice to get some footage from above.
Yeah.
Doug? Want to climb up that mast up there?
You guys owe me one.
Yay! Yay! Yay!
When does this stop? Oh, this is crazy. Mommy!